The first businesses in Foster City catered to a certain demographic. However, as the years went on and the population grew, the ethnicity within the population started to change, making Foster City take a look at itself and adapt.
You could see that market forces were changing. People were shopping differently than they used to. The shopping centers in town were failing. And the city had to change to keep up. And so the trick was, how could you keep the flavor and the basic intent of the original plan and yet move the city forward? You know, one of the important things for a city to keep its eye on is its demographics. It's easy to keep building things that relate to a demographic that may no longer be there. My impression of why it's changed and how it's changed and become more successful, I think, is that it began responding much more aggressively to the population changes. We had when I was here and still have an Asian population that is critical and important to the city. And the more you respond to what that portion of the population wants, restaurants or other stores and services, the more successful you're going to be. And it seemed to me that there was much more of an eye toward, well, who is Foster City and what are they looking for? I know that in the Marlin Cove Shopping Center, when we redeveloped that, we started with a different food market. And it just didn't fly. But when Ranch 99 came in, it seemed to me that the shopping center took off and became much more of a place not only to go food shopping, but I think that the Starbucks became much more popular. What was Chipotle at one time became another, I think a Korean restaurant responding to part of the population. I don't know if it was city staff that made some of these changes. I don't know if it was solely the owners, but I think much more of a comprehensive look at who are we and responding that way.
Master plans change with time. You have to take into consideration the changes that take place in the demographics of the community, in the certainly the economic development of, for example, in our case, the whole peninsula and the Silicon Valley.
The creation of Silicon Valley brought in big name companies like Visa and allowed companies that were once small, like Gilead, to grow. Foster City and the City Council realized the opportunities available for Foster City and the importance of making sure the companies that come to Foster City are a part of the community.
You know, I think our location on the peninsula is an asset. We're in proximity to the big city of San Francisco to the north, San Jose to the south, East Bay across the bridge, I think has made an ideal location for companies to locate. I think my role as a council member is to make sure we listen to them, hear what they need, and try to provide a good surrounding area with anything that they might need.
You need to develop those relationships with your businesses, and in order to drive businesses, you need to be responsive to the business needs. You need to understand the business needs. And then you need to work to make sure those needs are met along with the needs of the community at large.
There's about 20,000 people who come into Foster City every day, and they call this place their daytime home. They're spending at least 8-10 hours here. And that daytime population needs to have amenities for them to use before work and during the hours of work and after. And that's where the small and mid-sized business could fill that gap. And this is very powerful because larger companies attract employees not just by the salaries and by the location, but what amenities and services they have for them where they work.
I believe that we're working on trying to maintain our small town way of life, but still be able to attract the businesses that we need for our residents to enjoy the area.
Foster City is not just focusing on the now, but planning for the future. The City Council has implemented an economic development plan that will bring in more businesses and further diversify the businesses within Foster City. And as technology continues to advance, things will continue to grow and change for the city.